मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट रिलेशंस प्रॉब्लम्स ओके नाउ टू सॉल्व सम मोर प्रॉब्लम्स बेस्ड ऑन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ रिलेशंस ओके नाउ वी हैव प्रॉब्लम नंबर 10 व्हाट इज दैट शो दैट द रिलेशन आर इन द सेट सेट ऑफ इंटीजर्स डिनोटेड बाय z इज गिवन बाय R is equal to order pair A comma B defined by such that 2 divides A minus B. Using this condition, show that the set R is an equivalence relation. No, after defined by R is equal to order pair AB such that 2 divides A minus B. Order pair AB means 2 divides A minus B. Using this. To prove that R is an equivalence relation. So you know the definition of equivalence relation. Three conditions are satisfied. Namely, it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Okay, reflexive means what? Same ordered pair belongs to R. Symmetric means AB belongs to R implies reverse process. BA is also belongs to R. Then transitive means AB belongs to R. And BC belongs to R implies AC belongs to R. Okay, now to prove one by one. So first one is to prove that it is reflexive relation. Order pair AB such that 2 divides A minus B. Mathematically you write like this. 2 divides. Read it as that notation indicate 2 divides A minus B. 2 divides A minus B means what? A minus B is divided by 2. Exactly what I make 2. Okay. Now here first one is reflexive relation. Reflexive order pair in 2 by 2. Same order pair AA. Whether it's satisfied or not. Let AA belongs to R. Implies. Here order pair AB such that 2 divides A minus B. By taking order pair AA, why we take same term? Because definition of reflexive is same order pair, isn't it? So this implies 2 divides A minus A. 2 divides A minus A. That is mathematically right. 2 divides notation. Read it as divides A minus A value 0. Is it 2 divides 0 or not? 2 divides 0 means what? 0 is divided by 2. Divide by 2 means 2 zeros are 0. That equals remainder should be 0. Which is true? Is it true or not? Yes, clearly it is true. Right? Therefore, AA belongs to R for all A belongs to the set of integer Z. Hence, R is reflexive. Agutala, clearly R is reflexive. By taking AA, such that 2 divides A minus A is 0. 2 divides 0 means 0 is divided by 2. Dividend, divisor, remainder, quotient, all are integers. Clearly, which is true. Hence, R is reflexive relation. Okay. Then symmetric. Symmetric in 2 by 2. AB belongs to R. To prove that BA belongs to R. AB belongs to R means that is given. 2 divides. Divides denoted by the notation. 2 divides A minus B. Now here A and B are set of integers. If take one particular example. 2 divides. Take A value is set of integers. Say A. B value is 2. Right? So 2 divides A minus B. 8 minus 2. That is 2 divides. 8 minus 3 is 6. Is it 2 divides 6 or not? 2 divides 6 means 6 is divided by 2. Agutare divide agutare. Okay. Now this is A. That is B. 2 divides A minus B. 8 minus 2. That is 2 divides 6. Implies 2 divides reverse BA. What is B value 2? A value A. That is 2 divides 2 minus 8 minus 6. Is it 2 divides minus 6 or not? Yes. 2 into minus 3. That is equal to minus 6. 2 divides minus 6 means what? Minus 6 divided by 2. Is it satisfied or not? Is it true or not? Yes, clearly it is true. So in general, 2 divides A minus B. This implies, therefore, 2 divides B minus C is also satisfied. So 2 divides A minus B means what? B minus A means what? BA belongs to R. Like AB belongs to R implies BA belongs to R. Therefore, R is symmetric. Clear? R is symmetric. 3 mark question. Then third condition, to prove that R is transitive relation. Definition of transitive. AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R, implies AC belongs to R. Now here take third one. Let AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R. Now to prove that AC belongs to R. AB belongs to R means 2 divides A minus B. Right? Then what about BC belongs to R means 2 divides B minus C. Okay. Now we take one simple example. 2 divides, take 3 numbers. A value 8, B value 2. Okay. Then C value, or if you take A value 8, B value 6, C value is 2. Okay. Now 2 divides A minus B, 8 minus 6. And 2 divides B minus C, 6 minus 2. That is 2 divides 8 minus 6 is how much? 2. Clearly 2 divides 2? Yes. Then 2 divides 6 minus B is 4. 2 divides A minus B, 2 divides B minus C. Okay. This implies, you know that by using the laws of divisibility, 2 divides 2 and 2 divides 4. Are they satisfied? Yes. And those two. 2 divides 2 and 2 divides 4 implies, is it 2 divides 2 plus 4? Your fragment is satisfied of them already. 2 divides 2 plus 4. 2 plus 4, that is 2 divides 2 plus 4 value 6. Is it 2 divides 6? Obviously true. Now in general, A divides B, laws of divisibility. A divides C implies A divides B plus C whole square. Similarly, A divides B minus C whole square. Similarly, A divides B into C. All are satisfied. These are laws of divisibility. A divides B and A divides C implies A divides add these to B plus C. Take this example. 2 divides 2, 2 divides 4, add those 2. 2 plus 4, 6. Clear it 2 divides 6. You will to satisfy IL by 4. A divides B and A divides C. Divide IL by 4. Then to prove that A divides B plus C. Addition of 2 numbers is also divisible to whole square. Then 2 divides A divides B minus C. Similarly, A divides product of 2 terms B into C. Now here, 2 divides A minus B and 2 divides B minus C. This implies add those two, 2 divides A minus B plus B minus C. A minus B means 2 value. B minus C means 4 number. Add these two, 2 plus 4. 2 under arrow A minus B. 4 under arrow B minus C. Simplify, 2 divides minus B plus B cancel. 2 divides A minus C. So 2 divides A minus C means 4. Order period AC belongs to R. Now by taking AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R implies AC belongs to R. Therefore R is what? Transitive. Hence R is transitive. Therefore all three conditions are satisfied. Hence R is an equivalence relation. R is an equivalence relation. No, equivalence relation. All three conditions are satisfied. Clear, students? Okay. Next, problem number 11. 11th problem. No, problem number 11. Show that the relation R in the set L of all lines in a plane given by R is equal to ordered pair L1, L2. L1, L2 are the lines. Such that line 1 and line 2. Such that line 1 is perpendicular to line 2. No, ordered pair L1, L2 are the different better. L1, L2 means line 1 is perpendicular to line 2. Is symmetric, but neither reflexive nor transitive. Only it is symmetric, but not reflexive, not transitive. Reflexive agodilla, transitive agodilla, or symmetric agote. Check maadi agote. You know the definition of symmetry. AB belongs to R implies BA belongs to R. Okay. AB belongs to R implies BA belongs to R. Now, first one is symmetric agote. Let L1, L2 belongs to R implies L1 L2 means what? L1 L2 define what is that? This implies L1 is perpendicular to L2. Now read, this is line 1. This is L1. This is L2. Now here L1 is perpendicular to L2. Correct? L1 is perpendicular to L2. This is L1, this is L2. So definition of symmetry, L1 N2 belongs to R implies reverse. L2 L1 is also belongs to R or not? Check it. This is L1, this is L2. L1 is perpendicular to L2. Implies, is it L2 is perpendicular to L1? How to tell it? L1 is perpendicular to L2 implies reverse. L2 is also perpendicular to L1. Obviously these two. So L1 is perpendicular to L2. This implies therefore L2 is also perpendicular to L1. L2 is perpendicular to L1, that is nothing but L2, L1 belongs to R. Perpendicular line is always symmetric, isn't it? So L1, L2 belongs to R implies L2, L1 is also belongs to R. Therefore R is symmetric. Clear? R is symmetric. Okay. Next. But neither reflexive nor transitive. Reflexive means what? Same ordered pair. That is the same ordered pair. L1, L1. Check maadi. L1, L1 to one pair. L1, L1, it means what? L1 is perpendicular to L1 itself. One day like that. That line is perpendicular to itself? No. But that line is parallel to itself, but not perpendicular to itself. Is it reflexive? No. Parallel line is reflexive, but perpendicular line is not reflexive. So how to write? Now here L1 cannot be perpendicular to itself. Line 1 is not perpendicular to itself. Therefore L1, L1 does not belong to R. Hence R is not reflexive. It is not reflexive, only it is symmetric. Is it transitive? Check one of the transitive equation. Take three lines. Definition of transitive. L1, L2 and L2, L3 implies L1, L3. Check one of the equation. So look here. This is L1. This is L2. L1 is perpendicular to L2. How the? So this is L2, that is L1. L1 is perpendicular to L2. This is L3 line. L2 is perpendicular to L3. Correct and right? L1 is perpendicular to L2 and L2 is perpendicular to L3 implies L1 is perpendicular to L3 is it L1 is perpendicular to L3? No, it is parallel. So now transitive is not satisfied. Now here L1 is perpendicular to L2 and L2 is perpendicular to L1. That is L1, L2 belongs to R and L2, L3 belongs to R. Means L1 is perpendicular to L2 and L2 is perpendicular to L3. This implies L1 is not perpendicular to L3. That is line 1, line 3 are not perpendicular, does not belong to R. Perpendicular line is not transitive, remember. Perpendicular line is not reflexive, but only perpendicular line is symmetric. Therefore, R is not transitive. However, perpendicular line, it is only symmetric, but not reflexive as well as transitive. Whereas parallel lines, parallel lines is reflexive, symmetric, transitive. All three conditions are satisfied. Therefore, parallel line is an equivalence relation. But perpendicular line is not an equivalence relation. Perpendicular line is only symmetric, but not reflexive and transitive. I don't know, students. So, umba easy is a correct concept. Okay? Problem number 12. Very simple question. Show that the relation R in the set consisting of three elements 1, 2, 3. Given by R is equal to ordered pairs 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 2, 2, 3 is reflexive but neither symmetric nor transitive. similar to previous example, previous problem number 11. Okay, no redo, reflexive agute, but not symmetric and transitive. Illi nimu R value kodbidina. Idu nimu nodidaga ayda hogu nimu. So reflexive maakbekara en irbeku? Same order pair. In the given set A containing three elements, 1, 2, 3, we have three same ordered pairs. Muru ordered pair irbeku, same ordered pair irbeku. Idella check maadi 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Okay. Okay. Now, so your given data, R is the relation ordered pair 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 2, 2, 3. Now, is it reflexive or not? Obviously true. Yes. 1, 1 is there, belongs to R, 2, 2 belongs to R, 3, 3 belongs to R. In the set containing three elements, we have same three ordered pairs. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 belongs to R. Clearly, R is reflexive. How do you know it? R is reflexive because same ordered pair in general A belongs to R. Right? Next, symmetry. Definition of symmetry. AB belongs to R implies BA belongs to R. Check it. Now 1, 2 belongs to R implies what is Kana's part? 2, 1. Is it 2, 1 is there in the set R? No. 2, 3 belongs to R implies Kana's part. Is it 3, 2 belongs to R? No. Now here R is not transitive. R is not symmetric. R is not symmetric. Because 1, 2 belongs to R, but Kana's part 2, 1, 2, 1 does not belong to R. 2, 1 does not belong to R. Reverse process is not the R set. So that is not symmetry. Then what about transitive? Definition of transitive. AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R implies AC belongs to R. AB. BC, AC. Check one way. 1, 2 belongs to R. Okay. 2, 3. This is A, this is B, this is B, that is C. 1, 2 belongs to R. 2, 3 belongs to R. Implies R. 2 vanish. 1, 3. 1, 3 belongs to R. I can go re. 1, 2 is A. 2, 3 is A. You have to come in A. Implies A. 1, 3. Is it 1, 3 in the set R? No. Here R is not transitive. Why? Because in the given set of relation R, because 1, 2 belongs to R and 2, 3 belongs to R, but this implies 1, 3 does not belong to R. Therefore, it is not transitive, not symmetric, only it is reflexive. 3 mark. Clear, students? Okay. Next problem, read it carefully. Very simple problem. Show that the relation R defined in the set A of all triangles as R is equal to T1, T2, triangle denoted by T, T1, T2. There are so many triangles, namely T1, T2, T3, T4 and so on. Among those, they are pair T1, T2, such that T1, T2, it means what? That is given. T1 is similar to T2. Remember, all triangles are similar triangles. All triangles are similar. So, T1 is similar to T2. Then take another triangle. T2 is also similar to T3. T3 is similar to T4 because all triangles are similar triangles. So, T1 is similar to T2, is an equivalence relation. Obviously, it is true. It is an equivalence relation, first part. Second part, consider three right angle triangles. Three right angle triangles. T1 is the triangle with the sides are given 3, 4, 5. Okay. T2 is the triangle with the sides are 5, 12, 13. And T3 is the triangle with the sides are 6, 8, 10. Three triangles are given, with three sides are given. Now the question, which triangles among these three P1, P2, P3 are related to each other? It means whether triangle T1 is related to T2 or triangle T2 is related to T3 or triangle T1 is related to T3. Means related means whether T1 is similar to T2 or T2 is similar to T3 or T1 is similar to T3, using these three sides. Using those sides, we have to identify which triangles are related, means which triangles are similar to each other. Okay, now first part we should prove that it is an equivalence relation. You know the definition of equivalence relation. All three conditions are satisfied, right? Now namely reflexive, symmetric, transitive. Now to prove one by one. So first one is reflexive. Clearly, R is reflexive. Why? Because all triangles are similar. You know that every triangle is similar to itself. Because all triangles are similar. Triangle mele one triangle ekra same kodute do. So every triangle is similar to itself. Every line is parallel to itself. So then R is reflexive. That is L1 belongs to R. Because every triangle is similar to itself, means L1 is similar to itself, therefore R is reflexive. Then what about symmetric definition? AB belongs to R implies BA belongs to R. Now here AB, instead of A and B, here we are taking, let L1, L2 belongs to R. L1, L2 means P1, P2 belongs to R means P1 is similar to, triangle 1 is similar to, triangle 2 implies P2 is also similar to P1. P2 is also similar to P1. Why? Because all triangles are similar triangles. Therefore, P2, P1 is also belongs to R. So, D1, D2 belongs to R implies P2, D1 belongs to R. Therefore, R is what? Symmetric. Yeah? Then, transitive. Now, let T1, T2 belongs to R and T2, T3 belongs to R implies T1, T2 belongs to R means T1 is similar to T2. T2, T3 belongs to R means T2 is similar to what? T3. T1 is similar to T2. One triangle ide. Aa triangle mele innond triangle hakidive. Eradu triangle similar agide. Aa second triangle mele mattond triangle tagondideve. Adu kuda similar ide. Middle triangle tagu hakbidi. Is it first triangle is similar to third triangle? Yes, obviously true, because all triangles are similar. Therefore, P1 is also similar to what? Third triangle P3 implies P1, P3 is also belongs to R. So T1, T2 belongs to R and T2, T3 belongs to R implies P1, P3 belongs to R. Therefore, R is what? Transitive. R is transitive. Hence, R is reflexive, R is symmetric and R is transitive. Therefore, R is transitive. So, all three conditions are satisfied. Hence, R is an equivalence relation. R is an equivalence relation. First part is over. Second part, here, consider three right angle triangles P1 with sides. Now here P1 is the side. Second part also, P1 is the side. P1 is the triangle with the sides. What are the sides? 3, 4, 5. P2 is the side. P2 is the triangle with the sides. What are those? 5, 12, 13. And P3 is the triangle right triangle with the sides, namely 6, 8, 10. Now the question, which triangles among P1, P2 and P3 are related? It means whether P1 is similar to P2 or P2 is similar to P3 or P1 is similar to P3. Okay, now you know the concept. If the triangles are similar, you know that in earlier classes we have learned in 10th standard, if two triangles are similar, condition, corresponding sides are proportional. Corresponding sides are proportional. Now here, take one by one. So take first triangle and second triangle. Now P1 by T2. In P1 is the triangle with sides are 3, 4, 5. P2 is the triangle with sides are 5, 12, 13. Now take one by one. Given one, take P1 and T2. 3 by 5. Corresponding sides are proportional. 3 by 5 is equal to 4 by 12 is equal to 5 by 13. Are they equal? Whether 3 by 5 is equal to 4 by 12 is equal to 5 by 13? No, which is not true. Which is not true. So, P1 is not, therefore, P1 is not related to T2. P1 is not related to T2. Let's take T2 and T3. T2, T3, don't worry. T2, T3 sides 5, 12, 13, 6, 8, 10. 5 by 6 is equal to 12 by 8 is equal to 13 by 10. Are they equal? 5 by 6 is same as 12 by 8 is same as 13 by 10. No, again, which is not true. Idu kuda true agilla. Which is not true. Therefore, T2 is not related to what? T3. So T1, T2 agilla, T2, T3 no agilla. Take T1 and T3. And take P1 and T3. T1 is the triangle size 3, 4, 5. T3 is the triangle size 6, 8, 10. Take this one, 3 by 6. First triangle and third triangle is equal to 4 by 8 is equal to 5 by 10. Is it true? 3 by 6 is nothing but 3 ones are 3 twos are 1 by 2. Right? 4 by 8 is nothing but 4 ones are 4 twos are 1 by 2. 5 by 10 is nothing but 5 ones are 5 twos are. This is 1 by 2, that is 1 by 2, that is also 1 by 2. All are equal. Which is true? How is it? This is true. Yeah, they are together. T1 and T3 are related to each other. Therefore, T1 is related to what? T3. Dear students, remember, two triangles are similar. Condition, corresponding sides are proportional. That is the condition for similar triangles. Idea manpala? Okay. T9 is not motivated. Okay, students. Problem in this type. Give an example of a relation which is symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive. Second one, transitive but neither reflexive nor symmetric. Third one, reflexive and symmetric but not transitive. Fourth one, reflexive and transitive but not symmetric. And finally, symmetric and transitive but not reflexive. Each result carries one mark. They may ask in final exam. Give an example of a relation which is symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive. So you can give general example or you take particular example. Okay. Now look here. So first one. Let A is a set consisting of 3 elements. 1, 2. Or the 4 elements. In a way, symmetric a way, reflexive, transitive, higher bar. So, how are the R after a very good? Symmetric are becoming AB implies BA. Okay. So, we can take 1, 2, 2, 1. No, really. Is it symmetric? 1, 2 belongs to R implies 2, 1 belongs to R. Is it symmetric or not? Clearly, it is symmetric. Isn't it? Is it reflexive? Reflexive one line, same order carry wave. Is there same order carry in R? No. Is it transitive? 1, 2 belongs to R, 2, 1 belongs to R implies 1, 1 belongs to R. Is there? No. So clearly, R is symmetric. R is symmetric. but not reflexive and transitive. Reflexive agudela, transitive agudela. Because ya kagudela 1 1 2 2 3 3 does not belongs to R. Same order that does not belongs to R. And which is not transitive. 1 2 belongs to R. And 2 1 belongs to R implies 1 1 does not belongs to R. 1 1 R will be R. So this is only symmetric but not reflexive as well as transitive. इधर आप लोग बोलिए बोलती हूँ अथवा general example या ऊपर बोलो perpendicular line is symmetric. L1 is perpendicular to L2. It is symmetric. L1 is perpendicular to L2 implies L2 is perpendicular to L1. But it is not reflexive. Is it line 1 is perpendicular to itself? No. And it is not transitive. L1 is perpendicular to L2. Okay. And L2 is perpendicular to L3. Okay. Implies is it L1 is perpendicular to L3? No. So you can give that general example. Perpendicular line is symmetric but not reflexive and transitive. Adhano bari bodu. Okay. Then second one nodi enide. Give an example of relation which is transitive but not reflexive and symmetric. Reflexive symmetric ayirvaga transitive matra irbeku. Okay. Yavudu general example korbodu. Yavudu less than. A is less than A? No. 2 is less than 2? No. It is not reflexive. 2 less than 3 implies is it 3 less than 2? No. That is not symmetric. Is it transitive? Yes. 2 less than 3. 3 less than 4 implies what? 2 less than 4. So that less than is transitive but not reflexive and symmetric. Similarly, greater than is transitive but not reflexive and symmetric. Okay. Or if take particular example like A is the set consisting of 3 elements. And R is equal to R after every transitive IR vehicle, reflexive symmetric IR bar. How the transitive IR vehicle? 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 1. Is it transitive or not? Yes, A, B, B, C implies AC. 1, 2, 2, 3 implies 1, 3. Is there clearly R is transitive? R is not reflexive. Reflexive can be because same order pair does not belong to R. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, R is not. It is not reflexive. And R is not symmetric. Symmetric can be because 1, 2 belongs to R implies 2, 1 does not belong to R. It is only transitive but not reflexive and symmetric. Okay? Similarly, third question. Third is already give an example of relation which is reflexive and symmetric but not transitive. Reflexive irbeku, symmetric irbeku, transitive ayirbadu. Now take particular example. Let A is a set consisting of 3 elements 1, 2, 3. R is equal to. ये नहीं करवे को रे थर्ड वन नो रिफ्लेक्सिव सिमेट्रिक करवे रिफ्लेक्स करवे को सिमेट्रिक करवे बट नॉट ट्रांजिटिव हाँ रिफ्लेक्सिव सिमेट्रिक करवे कर दो ना रिफ्लेक्सिव आप बता रहे हैं ना बता को 1 1 2 2 3 दिस इज रिफ्लेक्स सिमेट्रिक 1 2 2 1 2 3 3 2 ओके हाँ चेक इट चेक पॉइंट वन बाय वन Is it reflexive? Obviously true. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Same order pair belongs to R. Clearly it is reflexive. Is it symmetric? Yes. 1, 2 belongs to R implies. Reverse. 2, 1 is also belongs to R. Then 2, 3 belongs to R implies. 3, 2 is also belongs to R. Isn't it? It is symmetric. Is it transitive? Check it. 1, 2 belongs to R. 2, 1 belongs to R implies. 1, 1 belongs to R. Here. Okay, next. 1, 2 belongs to R, 2, 3 belongs to R. 1, 2 belongs to R and 2, 3 belongs to R implies what? 1, 3 belongs to R. 1, 3 is there? No. Agadastha Modmar, though, to verify all order pairs, all order pairs will check ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ನೀವು ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ 1 2 2 1 2 ಒಟ್ರಿ 1 1
yes sir 1 1 is there it is standing to
no take any other order pair different order pair ತಗೊಂಡ ಅವು ಸರಿ ಸೋಡಬೇಕು 1 2 2 3 2 vanish 1 3 is there
no
so 2 3 3 2 3 vanish 2 2
yes
here okay then 3 3 3 2 3 vanish 2 3 2 3 2 is there but ಇದನ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡಾಗ 1 2 2 3 1 3 does not belong to R to verify all order pairs okay now here clearly R is reflexive and symmetric reflexive ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಇದು symmetric ಆಗುತ್ತೆ but not transitive but not transitive because ಯಾಕ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ 1 2 belongs to R and 2 3 belongs to R implies order pair 1 3 does not belong to R so it is not symmetric it is not transitive but it is reflexive and symmetric here similarly fourth one give an example of relation which is reflexive and transitive but not symmetric symmetric I am want to reflexive beko transitive beko again let A is the set A is the set consisting of three elements say 1 2 3 R is equal to R define ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಯಾಕಬೇಕು reflexive ಇರಬೇಕು transitive ಇರಬೇಕು so ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ reflexive ಅಂದ್ರೆ 1 1 2 2 3 3 ಮೂರು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಇರಲೇಬೇಕು ಅಲ್ಲವೇ so ಅದನ್ನ set A contains three elements we got three same order pairs then it is reflexive next ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ 1 ನೋಡಿ reflexive ಆಗಬೇಕು transitive ಆಗಬೇಕು but not symmetric is it reflexive yes is it transitive transitive check ಮಾಡಿ 1 1 1 2 1 vanish 1 2 ಇದೆ ತಾನೇ 1 2 2 2 2 vanish 1 2 2 2 2 vanish 1 2 is there
yes
so it is reflexive and transitive is it symmetric no 1 2 belongs to R I'm a spot. Now go. 2-1. Is there 2-1 belongs to R? No. So clearly, R is reflexive and transitive, but not symmetric. Symmetric agodilla. Yak agodilla give reason because 1 comma 2 belongs to R implies 2 comma 1 does not belong to R. So it is only reflexive and transitive but not symmetric. Dear students, next last one is fifth one. That is fifth one is give an example of relation which is symmetric and transitive but not reflexive. Symmetric irbeku, transitive irbeku, adralu reflexive agirbadu. A is the set consisting of three elements 1, 2, 3. Now R is equal to even I will make it symmetric and transitive, but not reflexive. So we take 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2. It is symmetric algebra. 2, 1, 1, 2, 1. Check it. Is it reflexive? No. 1, 1 again. In the set A contains three elements. We have three same ordered pairs. Then it is reflexive. 1, 1, 1 again. 2 2 illa 3 3 illa so that is not reflexive is it symmetric symmetric agutte nodri 1 2 belongs to R implies 2 1 belongs to R 2 2 belongs to R implies again reverse same 2 2 is also belongs to R it is symmetric is it transitive check it 1 2 belongs to R and 2 1 belongs to R 2 vanish 1 1 belongs to R right next 2 2 belongs to R then 2 1 belongs to R 2 vanish 2 2 belongs to R 2 1 belongs to R implies 2 1 belongs to R yes next 2 2 belongs that is 1 1 belongs to R and 1 2 belongs to R 1 vanish 1 2 belongs to R is there
yes
clearly R is symmetric R is symmetric and transitive symmetric agutte iru transitive agutte but not reflexive it is not reflexive why because 2 belongs to set A implies 2 does not belong to R, and 3 belongs to set A implies ordered pair, same ordered pair, 3 does not belong to R. Therefore, fifth example is symmetric and transitive but not reflexive. Clear, friends? So they will ask in final exam. Each question carries 1 mark. Only 1 mark question. Give an example of relation which is symmetric and symmetric but not reflexive and transitive, or which is transitive but neither reflexive nor symmetric, or reflexive and symmetric but not transitive. Okay, just leave it in a R set for the sum. Today mention more about the thing. At least it is perfect. This is for your reference. Your reference. I will tell you check my name. Okay, so these are the important results. Okay, so this completes relation part. Okay, so next class we will discuss about most important result, that is function. Okay, students, thank you.